Okay, everyone, this is my last post in this epic journey throughout the Pacific Northwest and at a medical conference here in Portland, Oregon. Again, my quest was to gather as much information as I can about conventional and complementary alternative medicine so that I can impart that to you. I attended several lecture sessions today, some of which I will get into detail with you, some of which were really more designed for the physician practitioner, so I will gloss over those. There were actually two sessions on microbiome. One was at the beginning of the day, one was at the end of the day, but I'll crunch those down into one informative package for you. So the microbiome, what is that? It's healthy bacteria, synergistic, symbiotic bacteria that live in us and on us. We are more bacteria by genes and DNA than we are human. The reason we don't walk around like a strange looking bacteria is because bacteria in scale, in size, are tiny compared to the much larger, though still microscopic, human cells. But we are made up of more microbiome than we are human. Your bacteria will use the enormous amount of information stored in their millions of genes to create and transform partially digested food into hundreds of thousands of metabolites. The microbiome influences eating behavior and dietary choices. If you have bad bacteria growing in you, they will tend to promote you consuming bad foods. If you have good bacteria growing in you, they will tend to promote you eating healthier foods. The gut-brain axis is the biochemical signaling that takes place between the GI tract, your gastrointestinal tract, and the central nervous system. The brain-gut axis includes the central nervous system, the autonomic nervous system, sympathetic, parasympathetic arms of the autonomic nervous system. It includes the enteric nervous, enteric meaning GI, enteric nervous system, and the vagus nerve, all combining information together. Your bacteria inform and create neurotransmitters for the brain and hormones for the body. And different bacteria work with different neurotransmitters and hormones. The gut microbiome is considered a virtual organ, separate and distinct microbiome for each section of the GI tract, upper intestine, lower intestine, separate, interconnected to the endocrine system. Certain bacteria trigger glandular production of hormones and neurotransmitters in the body. Certain bacteria produces and secretes them directly into the gut. We produce 90% of our serotonin, the happy neurotransmitter, the happy hormone, in the gut, not in the brain. It's affected by hormones and it modulates the systemic inflammatory process in the body. Dysbiosis, which is an overgrowth of the bad kind of bacteria, has been correlated and linked to cardiovascular disease, obesity, diabetes, PCOS for females, infertility in both males and females, anxiety and depression. Ask yourself, what is the most dangerous thing that we do? Is it smoking? Is it drinking? Is it doing drugs? No. The most dangerous thing that we do is eating and making poor choices around eating. Metabolic endotoxemia is essentially an innate immune response that becomes subclinical, persistent, and is low-grade chronic inflammation. Metabolic endotoxemia is a condition that's estimated to affect approximately a third of people living in the United States and in the Western population. To date, studies support a strong correlation between metabolic endotoxemia and the increased risk for cardiovascular disease, diabetes, obesity, autoimmunity, mood disorders, and certain types of cancer. And when we look at the microbiome, we have to understand that variety and taking a probiotic, eating fermented food is really important. And a variety of good bacteria that you get in, because each one is determinant and responsive for different neurotransmitters and different hormones. We have to recondition the gut. We have to reinforce those changes, those reconditions, with beneficial additions such as prebiotics. And we have to rebuild the intestinal mucosa. So microbiome, so important. If you followed this channel in the past, we've created some other videos specifically for microbiomes. I encourage you to check that out. The next lecture was on pharmaceutical drug development. And I'll just glance over this, but it was interesting. From start to launch, most pharmaceuticals on average take 12 years. An average of $1 to $2 billion is spent on each and every drug in order for the FDA to approve it through a long process lasting on average 12 years. Patents only last 20 years. That means 20 minus 12 is 8. That means that most drug companies, assuming that it's approved after spending $1 to $2 billion on the medication going through trials, they only have 8 years to really make money. That's why they're so aggressive at their marketing techniques. They have 8 years before it becomes generic. Now, what I took away from this was that generic drugs and botanical, herbal, nutraceutical agents are treated in very similar ways, and to go through the process of getting a substance approved, getting it through the clinical trials, getting the FDA to wear a happy face that what you're doing is solid and what you're doing is based on scientific evidence, it's hard. And that's why we spend our time at Zenith Labs to make sure that all of the formulas that we come up with, the FDA is going to look at and say, you know what? They can go forward with that because they're not making outrageous claims. They're just simply stating the facts of the trials that the ingredients have shown over time. The next two lectures were for prescribing medications for diabetes and thyroid. Those two were really focused on me as the doctor and less on you as the patient. Of course, it will have ramifications because I learned some nuances about the new drugs for diabetes, which are coming out. I've learned some nuances about properly and accurately titrating doses for thyroid medications and individuals that suffer from low or high thyroid. So I took great notes, I assure you, but the information was really designed more for doctors and practitioners than patients. It's been a great conference. I know that learning is so important. It elicits and fosters the capacity for delight and wonder within me, but ultimately it keeps you informed. Because if you're better informed about your health conditions, about medications, about supplements and botanicals and nutraceuticals, you can make smarter decisions to create and maintain optimal health and wellness. Thanks so much for going on this journey with me. I go back home, I hop on a plane later today. Conference is over, my 3 week long trip is over, and I'm happy to be reunited again with my family. I wanna know where you're from, what your experiences are. I love that you guys are watching and paying attention so that you can create better health and wellness. Again, we've made some other videos. Check out the channel. Make sure that you like it, subscribe to it, share it with your friends and loved ones. This is not me and you. This is us. This is us trying to educate the community so that you can take better care of yourself. Never doubt that a small group of people can make a powerful change in life. Of course, we've created supplements at Zenith Labs. I encourage you to check those out. We have a Facebook page, a YouTube page, Instagram page. I encourage you to check those out. Subscribe and share with your friends and loved ones. Because this is our journey together. The more I learn, the more I can teach, and the more you will know. Thanks so much for your time and attention. I'm Dr. Ryan Shelton.